Scott Major, and just so you understand that I am very, very personally empathizing with you. I have been through 12 storms on my own. I've handled 24 storms around the country. I am a national disaster guy, if you will. What I'm here to talk to you about, I've got an hour's worth of material I got to do in 7 minutes. So I'm going to start it here, and then I'm going to walk right out there and continue it as soon as we get done. But the whole key right now for you as individuals is to understand how you get money, because really that's what matters. And there's a component of FEMA on one side, and there's a component of insurance on the other. I'm going to spend my time talking a little bit about insurance, what you should think about, what kind of policies you have, whether you should hire a public adjuster or a lawyer or neither, what the benefits and drawbacks are in the short time that I have. First of all, the number one thing that you need to understand when you want to get money from any of these organizations, public or private, is you have to have documentation, photographs, video, as much documentation as you can have. Take a picture of every aspect, of every corner of that, and write down exactly where it is and what the damage is. And you're going to give that package, whether it's to FEMA or to your insurance company, and you're going to let them know that this is the damage that you have. If you have contents, list all the items that you have. Find out exactly what they cost. Find out how much it costs to replace them. The important thing to remember to start out fundamentally is I have to prove that I have damage, and I have to prove that damage was causally related to a flood or to a wind event or what have you. Now, how do I know what policies I have and what I do, and how do I get the insurance company to pay me? Two kinds of principal policies: homeowners, flood. Okay, homeowners covers the structure, the building envelope, typically from wind events. Okay, the roof gets torn off. Things happen as a result of that. Flood waters come in and enter your property. In a homeowner's insurance policy, there are four kinds of insurance within that policy. It is found on page one of your insurance policy, called the declarations or deck sheet. Everybody, when you leave today, if you do not have your insurance policies, you're going to pick up a phone, you're going to call your insurance agent, and you're going to say, I want, quote, a certified copy of the insurance policy. That's what you say. Why? Because it has all the pages, including those pages they sent you every other month that you didn't understand what they were when they sent them to you, saying endorsement or rider or what have you. So it's very important. Your insurance agent also must participate in your claim. When you call them on the phone, they're not to say, great, I'd love to help you. Here's the 1-800 number. Wish you the best of luck. They're supposed to take an active role. If you want them to take an active role, you talk to them. And most importantly, you write them. Thank you for agreeing to help me. I expect weekly written progress notes from you on what you've accomplished in getting my claim paid. Love and kisses, you. If the person doesn't respond, and a week later you write the same thing. I wrote you last week. You said you were going to do it. Love and kisses, you. The whole concept is we have to be aggressive in our claims. Once we get our documents, once we have photographs and we have information, we want to have substance, reports, or things which are going to support our claim. Those are things like estimates, reports from experts. If gentlemen in the back, Mr. Phelps and the Browners and Dobbins, if you just stand up for a second, this is a team of experts that are engineers, window experts, and other people that are going to be in the back of the room to answer any question you have, whether it's an elevation issue, whether it relates to how you tell your properties, thank you very much, gentlemen, whether it's how you determine the damage of your property, whether it's, hey, most people don't realize that almost everybody has window damage, even though your window isn't broken. And you're not going to realize that until 6 months, 2 years, 3 years down the road, okay? And so you can go back in the back of the room and talk to them. What's important to me is not necessarily whether you hire a lawyer or you don't hire a lawyer. It fundamentally starts with, I have to have as much documentation on my side. I used to be the former national counsel for one of the largest insurance companies in the world. We paid when people documented things. We didn't when they didn't. We paid when people bugged us. We didn't when they didn't, okay? So there's no fooling around here. It's fasten your seatbelts, let's go. We're gonna get this claim, you know, documented, and we're gonna get it to the insurance company. How do you get the claim started? You gotta call your insurance company, you gotta write your insurance company. When you get a claim number on the phone, you get that person's email address. You know, bob.com, great, thank you very much. Whatever he tells you on the phone, you hang up, you immediately write him, dear Bob, thanks very much for telling me that you're gonna have an adjuster out to my property within 3 days. I'll look forward to doing that. Thanks very much that you're going to have an adjuster out on December 4th at 3 p.m. When they don't show up December 4th at 3 p.m., at 3:15, you write them a letter. Dear Bob, You told me you're going to have a guy out here at 3:15. He wasn't there. I expect you to write me immediately and to tell me when you are going to have a guy out there. Love and kisses you. If he doesn't do it the next day, you write him again. And you write him again. And then you create this track record. Then when you go to a supervisor, it's not a pissing contest between you and somebody saying, I didn't tell him that, I did tell him that. Every time you speak to someone, you write a letter. Every time they speak to you, you write a letter. When somebody comes out to your property and says, wow, you have over $100,000 of damage, but I'm gonna get you $10,000 right now. That's garbage. If you have over $100,000 of damage, you get over $100,000. When they give you the $10,000, you write them, dear so-and-so, thank you very much for agreeing to pay me over $100,000. I only received 10. Please explain in writing each and every reason why it is you're not paying those claims. If you have a list of items, if you get your experts out there and they do a report, I send the reports in to the adjuster and I say, here, you have a certified engineering report. It lists 26 things that have to be fixed. Please write me within the next 2, 3, 5 business days and tell me whether you're going to pay for all those or tell me which items you don't agree to, what the support for that is, and write back to me. Love and kisses me. If they don't write, if they don't respond, I write them and say they haven't responded, and I include that. This is the way you get paid. If you want to get money, which all of you want now, and believe me, I'm telling you, from living through these storms, including Cat 5 storms, this is the way to get money. Get every one of your friends to file claims. Get everybody in your block to file claims. Talk to everyone. Because if the guy at 40 Belmont has a broken window and he got paid and you didn't for the same window, you take a picture of his window, you give it to them, and they have to pay you. What people don't realize is that a lot of times your neighbors and other people around might get paid some things and you think, well, why should I get paid? Well, if they have the same problem you do, you're entitled to get paid. And if not, you're going to document that. Whether that's documenting that on the insurance side or on the FEMA side. The most important thing, as I'm saying, is you see how intense I am? That's what you got to be with these claims. You want to get money? There's a million claims being made. What number do you want to be? 967,000 or number one? You want to get paid? You document. You get as many reports as you can. If you're getting an estimate, number one, always have a licensed person do it. A licensed general contractor, a licensed plumber. Get 2 estimates at least for every item that you want. If you have broken pipes and you have a roof problem, then get 2 estimates on each one, because then nobody can say, oh, it was your buddy Bob jerking up the price to try to get more money. And you'll see that the estimates will be pretty competitive amongst themselves. You send them in, you're always sending information in, and you're saying, pay me. If you're not paying me, write me, not call me, write me and tell me why you're not paying me. You don't think this works? Start doing it, okay? When I file claims and I get people to do this, they get paid. And that's what you have to do. And the hardest thing about this process is to understand that there's a lot of stress, there's a lot of frustration, there's a lot of problems. You gotta focus on the opportunities. You gotta focus on how do I get my money and how do I get the money from my community. And the way to do that is to use that documentation tactic, to use that writing tactic, to be aggressive. Now finally, before I depart, what should you use? Should you do this on your own? Should you get an attorney? Should you get a public adjuster, some combination? It's really up to you. If you feel comfortable that you can document these claims well enough and you can write these letters and you can get knowledgeable, or you can have the person who comes out and does your estimate help educate you as to what to write, you certainly can handle these claims yourself. You don't need anybody. However, generally speaking, public adjusters and lawyers tend to know, who are specialists in these areas, tend to know more about the claims and how to process them. What's the pros and cons? A public adjuster is great because they generally understand adjusting and they know how to communicate with insurance companies. They can go out, they usually charge 5 to 10%, you know, for a claim. You're not really paying out of pocket. They get money, you get some money. Benefit is they can process your claim fairly quickly, they can do their own estimate. What's the disadvantage? The disadvantage is they're not lawyers, so they can't sue. If I'm the insurance company and I know the guy can't sue me, I have less of a motivation to pay. That doesn't mean they won't pay. I'm just telling you the pragmatic realities. For those of you who are out there who got wrongfully denied and you're just sitting around saying, what do I do? You know, you got to have an advocate to fight for you. The disadvantage of a lawyer is that when you have a lawyer, you're going to pay generally a higher percentage. Now, sometimes lawyers will help you because what they'll do is they will front costs. They'll go out and get those great experts that are in the back of the room, and they'll get all these reports, and they'll submit a 200-page document into the insurance company. When I do these claims, it's like the Prince of Darkness. I get them these detailed boxes and documents and 150 pictures and descriptions of descriptions and explanations, and I say, tell me what you're not going to pay, or pay me. And let me tell you something, they got a problem. Because under the insurance law in every state in this country, they are required to investigate your claim. They are required to respond to every claim of damage that you have documented. They cannot say, I am too busy. They cannot say, we have a lot of claims. They cannot say, cut me a break. They cannot say, I'm in Kansas and I'll get to you in the next couple of weeks. When they do, you write them. So that is a short, squeezed primer in to what it is. I've talked to a lot of town meetings over this past time, and what I want to emphasize to you is to try to make sure that you think about these things, you document your claims, and you be strong. I appreciate your time. I'll be in the back, and I'm going to continue to give all kinds of letter writing strategies and other types of things that will help you in the back. Thanks for your time.